It was the night before Christmas, and I was reading the Word. Every prophecy was coming true. I know this sounds absurd. All the signs of the end are happening so fast, there's no way this world is going to last. As I dozed off to sleep, I gave the Lord a quick prayer. "Bless my dreams," I said, "and give me something to share." And as I dozed off and was beginning to nod, I started to see visions that struck me as odd. 'Twas nearly the end, with a world filled with sin. All of heaven was quiet, not even an amen. There on the throne sat the Father with care, in hopes the Lord Jesus would soon be there. And next to the throne, for all to see, was the book of life that keeps track of you and me. Above the throne was strung a great banner. It kept track of every saved soul in quite a heavenly manner. When out of the east there arose such a shout, I sprang from my bed to see what was about. Away to my window I flew so fast, I looked to the heavens and I saw Him at last. The Father stood up, full of might and great power. He looked to His right and said, "Son, now is thine hour." The Father gave a quick wink and a nod, and with great glory and pride, He said to the Son, "Go get your bride." Then all of a sudden, from the skies above, the clouds departed and I saw a white dove. There was lightning and thunder and a great trumpet blast. I hoped and I prayed I would not be last. Then I heard a great shout and He yelled out my name, "Come up hither, for you have no more shame." My heart was racing and pounding and then skipped a beat. Next thing I know, I was there at His feet. With all power, glory, and might, there was my Savior. Oh, what a sight! I looked at those scars, foot, hands, and face, but as I looked at His eyes, all I saw was grace. He gave me a hug and a warm embrace, saying, "Don't worry, child, you've won this race. Enter in, good and faithful servant," He spoke. "I've prepared all this for you. It's not a joke. With this ring and this crown, I take you, my bride, to be my faithful wife, my glory, my pride." Then the gates were shut and the wedding began. But down on earth, His wrath was on man. For 7 years, all the world will stress wrath and judgment. Oh, what a mess! Many will fall to their knees and shout, "Lord, forgive us and help us out." But for the rest that are left behind, their sin-filled life has left them blind. He called out their sins one by one, so prideful, so boastful, so full of hate. You could have repented, but now it's too late. Because you are foolish and took the wrong path, now you will experience God's just wrath. There's only one way to heaven, accept the gift from the Son. His life for your sins paid in full. It's finished. It's done. He conquered death and arose from the grave. He did it for you. Only He can save. With gnashing of teeth and shaking of fist, many will realize they're not on the list. "Oh Lord, check it twice. As far as the world, I'm pretty nice." The next thing I knew, I saw a long line. It stretched for miles, like a long grapevine. Millions of people were waiting to see and tell their story and give their plea. "But Lord, I have gone to that church all my life, and unlike most people, I have only had one wife. Every Saturday I went door to door, pushing a wake, watchtower, and more. I rode my bike with shirt and tie, giving out that other gospel, I would not lie. All roads lead to heaven, I've always been told. You're born that way, so be prideful and bold. But Lord, I gave at the office, and once to the poor. Surely that will get me into heaven. Now open that door." The Lord said, "Go away, you cannot stay. You've had your chance, now go away. I never knew you, you're not in the book. Here it is, now take a look." As I awoke from my dream and wonderful sleep, I looked, and behold, I started to weep. I was still in my bed, so I started to pray. Oh, thank you, Lord, for this kind day. I thank you, Lord, for the dream of warning. It's not too late. I won't have to go into mourning. A second chance to warn and say, give your life to Jesus. He's the only way. I knew from the dream and with all of my heart that soon that day will come that we will depart. But while time is left, there is much to do. Share the word and be so kind so that no one, not one, is left behind.
I'm never going to stop sharing the gospel and the ABCs of salvation because you just don't know. What's the A? The A is for admit or acknowledge that you sinned and that you need the Savior. This is what we were just talking about in 1 Thessalonians. It's a turning from and a turning to. It's really repentance in the sense that there's a change of mind. And you acknowledge, I've sinned against God. I've fallen short of the perfect standard of God's righteousness. I've transgressed God's law. Those Ten Commandments, I broke every single one of them, and then some. I even invented more and broke them too. Romans 3:10 says, there is no one righteous, not even one. Romans 3:23 says, all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. That's the bad news, and there's more bad news because there's a penalty for that sin. And that's what Romans 6:23 says. The penalty is the death penalty. The wages of sin is death. But here's the good news. Are you ready for some good news? Don't you hate it when somebody comes up to you and says, I got some bad news and I got some good news. Which one do you want first? To which I just usually respond, get thee behind me, Satan. I don't want any bad news. I've had enough bad news. I need some good news. Where's the good news? The good news. The gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. That's the A, here's the B. Pardon me. The B is for believe in your heart that Jesus Christ is Lord. And as Romans 10, 9 and 10 says, if you believe in your heart that God raised Jesus from the dead, you will be saved. Pretty simple, isn't it? Too simple, maybe. Lastly, the C. The C is for call upon the name of the Lord, or as Romans 10, 9 and 10 also says, confess with your mouth. If you confess with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. And here's why. For it is with your heart that you believe and are justified, and it is with your mouth that you confess and are saved. And lastly, Romans 10, 13. This seals the deal. All who call upon the name of the Lord will be saved. That's it. If you have never called upon the name of the Lord, maybe you're watching online, I implore you, this state of uncertainty that we're seeing in the world today, it's prophetic. It is setting the stage like never before. It is readying the world for this charismatic world leader to come on the scene. One has called him the man with the plan. And he will be seen as the Savior, solving all the problems economically, governmentally, religiously, bringing everyone together. A new world order, if you will. A one world religion, a one world government, and a one world economy. That's how we know. This is the last hour. The Lord is coming. Please stand, we'll pray. Thank you, Lord. Lord, thank you for the good news in a world filled with nothing but bad news. But thank you that the bad news can be the catalyst for the good news, the gospel of salvation. Lord, I pray if there's anybody here today in this church or watching online that has never called upon you, believing in their heart, trusting in you for the forgiveness of sins, acknowledging their sin, confessing you, Jesus, as Lord. I pray that they won't leave this church today without making the most important decision they'll ever make in their life for eternal life. And for those watching online, I pray that when this video ends, it'll be the beginning of new life in you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Come quickly, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.